The ensemble cannot be disguised. Not everybody can pull that off, but Mr. Big Shot can pull it off.
I do appreciate that, sir.
No question, no question about it. You heard him bring up Kyrie Irving.
Yeah.
How much do the Cavaliers miss this man? I know it's a rhetorical question almost, but I got to ask you.
I mean, it's invaluable. You know, you need a guy. You know, LeBron is going to be special every night. But you need a guy that can get going to let LeBron rest, either in the game or on the bench. Kyrie served as that guy, and nobody in the world can guard Kyrie Irving. So they miss him big time. I mean, LeBron he's been pretty special. He's gotten a little bit of help. Game, you never know which game, but they miss another stud like that.
Remind me of your position on the whole Kyrie departure from the perspective of looking at LeBron James, what he's going through in this NBA Finals, having to carry such a heavy load by himself. You're thinking, no, it was Dan Gilbert that elected to trade Kyrie, not LeBron, but in the same breath, did you do everything you could to keep him? What was your perspective on it then? What is it now?
I hated to see it happen, to be honest with you, and only because I just felt like they needed each other. Now it's proving to be that way. Now, both can be special in their own lane, but I felt like they needed each other if they're going to have a chance to compete with these Warriors, which that was even hard to do with those two guys. I respect the fact that Kyrie was like, listen, I feel like I'm just as good. You know, I don't get the credit. Let me go show that. So I respect that from Kyrie's perspective. But the one thing that always made me say, man, I just don't get it is, all you want is a chance, in my opinion, all you want is a chance to win every single year. And he had a free ride to that.
Oh. With that being said, we come back to game 40 NBA Finals tonight. LeBron and these Warriors going up against these Warriors. What can Cleveland do to pull out a game tonight?
One, they're going to have to get hot from the three-point line. Two, they're going to have to be very, very physical defensively. They're going to have to change up some of the schemes. You know, on KD's, who's gotten hot.
Be specific.
They did a good job.
I need specifics. They were switching bodies on him in game three, but that wasn't enough. What did they do in game four?
It didn't work. You might have to trap him. You know, they did a good job of trapping and taking Steph Curry out of game three. Mm-hmm. You're going to have to do more. You're going to have to do it with both guys. I mean, the problem is even a trap sometimes is not good enough for KD because he can see over top of it.
Their mentality was when you would listen to people critique the Cavaliers, they're talking about, well, if you trap KD, it's going to leave Steph open. It's going to leave Clay open because of the way they play. Isn't there a scenario or a situation where you could force what you did in the first go-round against these Cleveland Cavaliers years ago when Iguodala won the championship? You forced him to be the shooter. You could force Draymond to be the shooter. Why does it have to be Clay or Steph that's going to be open instead of one of those other guys?
Yeah, you run the risk because, you know, just say they have that death lineup that they have out there. You want Draymond or you want Iggy to be able to shoot threes or make plays. The problem is those two guys are so smart, bro. They find a way to make it happen, to get the ball to somebody. And don't forget about this. A lot of people fail to realize Cleveland don't have that same physical personnel defensively to be able to really contend with these guys. You got to be physical. Look what Houston did. You know, look what the teams that have beaten them once in a series, look what they've done to beat them. Cleveland don't have that kind of personnel.
We're looking at Larry Nance Jr. warm up right now behind us. Him, Jeff Green, Tristan Thompson. How much do those guys help in concert with Kevin Love in terms of that physicality? Still not physical enough?
No, they haven't been physical enough, in my opinion. Could they be? I think that they have the ability to be. I mean, you talk about those two guys. Look at Jeff Green here. You've seen Larry Nance. Two very athletic guys. You think athletically they should be able to match up. But it's not always about athleticism. You got to be smart. You got to have some grit, some grind in there. It's defense and all. It's about will. Can you impose your will? And right now, the Warriors are doing that.
It's the Big Shot, Chauncey Billups. I'm looking at the Golden State Warriors, and I got to tell you something. You're trying to find a sliver of hope. Flip side to it is that Steph Curry and Klay Thompson combined to shoot 3 of 15 from three-point range. Steph Curry shoots 1 of 10 from three-point range. Worst shooting night of his career as far as I'm concerned. Okay? Kevin Durant is the lone offensive player that shows up for you. If you want to count JaVale McGee and Sean Livingston, go right ahead, especially JaVale McGee. But ultimately, Klay Thompson, Steph Curry didn't show up, and the Cleveland Cavaliers still lost this game. How on earth could they possibly pull this particular game out? If you're Chauncey Billups, what are you telling them?
Listen, first of all, you got to make it a fight. You got to make it a fight out there.
Can you do that in today's game with these rules?
Well, not a real fight.
Okay.
Obviously not a real fight, but just every possession. It can't be nothing, no easy layups. They got to be picking themselves up off the ground. You got to run these guys off the three-point line, and you have to get hot on the other end from the three-point line. I don't know that they can do that.
I don't understand why J.R. Smith can't get going, because I see he's had his share of open shots. Every shot hasn't been contested. You see him walking in there now. I mean, he's got a smile on his face. I have no idea why.
He has
that smile there, a little swag. What are your expectations of him tonight? What does he have to do outside of making shots? I mean, I know he's got to make shots. Anything else?
Well, he has to be more focused on the defensive end. He really does. I mean, they get caught in these switch situations. Sometimes it's covered, sometimes it's shows and get back. JR, a lot of times, is getting confused in a lot of these matchups, costing them wide open threes for this guy, that guy. It's not always about shooting with JR. Think about it. When he made that leap, when we all, the whole world, thought he made that leap, it was because he was focused on the defensive end. He had become a guy that they could depend on. He struggled a lot. He's had a lot of lapses in this series on the defensive end. I'm not even talking about his shooting, which we know could be up and down, but they're going to need JR to be special. He was aggressive last game, but it didn't hold up.
Have the Warriors won these games, or have the Cavaliers lost it?
Man, you can look at this series so many different ways. I mean, it could be.
Well, where are you looking at it?
I feel like
Mr. Countdown. I'm talking to Mr. Countdown.
They lost an opportunity in game one. Cavs could win that game. And I thought the game was hanging in balance in game three. And I said it on our show afterwards. I thought LeBron was too passive in that fourth quarter. He was way too passive in that fourth quarter because he got the help that he needed. And then it was time for him to bring it home. And he was deferring to Kevin Love.
Some people are gonna look at you,
those guys.
Chauncey, they're gonna look at Chauncey Billups, and they're gonna say he had 19 points in the second half.
Yeah,
half of those came in the fourth quarter, more than half of it.
But guess what? There's some guys I don't care about stats. Mm-hmm. I don't care about none of that. If the game is on the line, 1 or 2 point game, 6 minutes left, I don't care if you had no points or 30. It's a new ball game right there. You got to bring your team home.
So is that your way of saying that coming into game four, LeBron James should be looking at himself based off of game three rather than his teammates?
Yes. Yes, no question about it, because his teammates came to work. And we never know who's going to show up to the arena with that team. They came to work the other night. It was in the balance, and I felt like Bron just kind of let off the gas a little bit.
If you had to pick a sleeper for Cleveland tonight that's going to step up and surprise us, who should it be? Anybody?
I like to see if they can get Kyle Korver some good shots, some good looks. But it's not like he's played bad. They've done a good job of game planning for him. They're switching every single pin down, which we know if he catches the ball on a dribble, he got to pass it right away.
You can't look at Tyronn Lue in that particular situation in terms of figuring out a way from a coaching standpoint to create shots for your best shooter?
Yeah, but what happens is this. You're looking at what lineups they put in the game. So now if you're waiting until that lineup comes in, are you really going to base everything for Kyle Korver off of what happens there? That could be in the middle of the third quarter for the first time. And you say, you hurry up and make it. You never know how the team is playing at that time. You might have somebody else going at that time. It's all situational.
Before I let you go, I'm going to ask everybody this question. LeBron James in free agency is coming up. He's expected to opt out of this contract. Even if he opt in, he could still opt in for the purposes of being traded. What are you anticipating will happen with LeBron James?
You know, the more and more I think about it, and I've held fast on, I don't think LeBron will leave, but I'm really starting to believe that he will. You know, and to be honest with you, I think he has a pass to do it now. He came back to Cleveland, gave him a championship. Gave it all he had this year. I mean, I think he took 2 years off of his career this year, how hard he had to play, not missing no games. He gave it all he had, and I think he deserves a fair shot to try to win out here. And if this is what it's going to be, people give him a pass to leave.
Appreciate you as always, man. Come
yes,
on.
Indeed.
I'll be watching you tonight in NBA Countdown. I ain't going to miss
yeah.
it. I promise you that. But coming up, it's a good time to be commissioner of the NBA, and Adam Silver has certainly done a great job during his short tenure. He'll join me next, and we'll get his thoughts on the finals and free agency. The commissioner, he's on the court. Steph Curry is on the court. Everybody's on the court. But my priority right now is getting set to talk to the commissioner of the National Basketball Association, Stephen A., with Commissioner Adam Silver, coming up next in a minute.